because he's got some questions for the rest of you. I told him I'd turn on my mic. We're good? All right. Let's see here, Pastor Ben. Get right to it. Do you trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, your Savior? Acknowledge him Lord of all and head of the church, and through him believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? Do you accept the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments to be, by the Holy Spirit, the unique and authoritative witness to Jesus Christ in the Church Universal and God's word to you? Do you sincerely receive and adopt the essential tenets of the Reformed faith as expressed in the confessions of our church as authentic and reliable expositions of what Scripture leads us to believe and do? And will you be instructed and led by those confessions as you lead the people of God? Will you be a minister of the word and sacrament in obedience to Jesus Christ under the authority of Scripture and continually guided by the confessions? Will you be governed by our church's polity, and will you abide by its discipline? Will you be a friend among your colleagues in ministry, working with them, subject to the ordering of God's word and spirit? Will you, in your own life, seek to follow the Lord Jesus Christ, love your neighbors, and work for the reconciliation of the world? Do you promise to further the peace, unity, and purity of the church? And will you seek to serve the people with energy, intelligence, imagination, and love? Will you be a faithful minister, proclaiming the good news in word and sacrament, teaching faith, and caring for people? Will you be active in government and discipline, serving in the governing bodies of the church? And in your ministry, will you try to show the love and justice of Christ? Great. And like I said, this isn't all about Ren today. Elder Jim has some questions for you as well.
Questions for us. Do we, the members of the church, accept Brian as our pastor, chosen by God as the voice of this congregation to guide us in the way of Jesus Christ? So
we do.
Do we agree to encourage her, to respect her decisions, and to follow her? Guides us, serving Jesus Christ, who alone is head of the church.
We do.
Do we promise to pay her fairly and provide her welfare as she works among us, to stand by her in trouble and share her joy? Will we listen to the word she preaches, welcome her pastoral care, and honor her authority as she seeks to honor and obey Jesus Christ, our Lord?
We do, and we will.
Amen. And as a sign of blessing, I invite you to extend a hand toward Pastor Ren as we pray over her. Yeah. Gracious God, continue to pour out your Spirit upon your servant Ren, so that she may continue to rightly to proclaim your word in Christ, from pulpit, table, and font, and in the words and actions of daily living. Increase in her the gifts of your Holy Spirit to build up the church, to strengthen the common life of your people, and to lead with compassion and vision in the walk of faith. And for the work of ministry, continue to give to your servant Ren and to all who serve as elders and deacons among your people gladness and strength, discipline and hope, humility, humor, and courage, and an abiding sense of your presence. Bless, we pray, this new call, O God, this call between Reverend Ren Cerna and the people of University Presbyterian Church here in Fresno. Grant them your Holy Spirit as they seek together the mind of Christ and work to do Christ's mission and ministry in this community and beyond. Give them joy in their service together, fruitfulness in their common ministry, and faithfulness in their mission. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Friend Serna, you are now a teaching elder in and for this congregation. Be faithful and true in your ministry, so that your whole life will bear witness to the crucified and risen Christ. Amen.